performance to football, tap dancing, sad kumma, and writing, of course. This conversation was an absolute delight for all of us. Thank you, sir. In poetry and prose, at 2, with Saurabh Sharma, Archna Sahni, and Vineet Bajpai, to be followed by 2 very interesting sessions. We hope to see you after lunch.
From his life, which forms a pivotal part of his book, which we are going to come to a little later, Saurabh. For now, what is it that prompted you to write? He is an associate director in Flipkart. Were you in that position when you wrote this
When
novel?
I started writing, it was back in 2011 when I was working with Coca-Cola. And so there was one music video which I saw, which actually had the same incident which I was going to narrate today. Where a guy does something for a girl in his teenage and how the girl reacts, you know, the typical mushy things. So I saw that video and I was like, this reminded me of what I did for that girl, although she didn't respond back. So I wrote a small story about it and posted it on Facebook. And that got pretty good, you know, 150 shares and all back in 2011. So I was like, how about knitting a story around it? And it was a 4-year journey. So I did not know if I was ever going to publish it. I just enjoyed writing and I kept writing. And the book then came out in 2016.
And I believe it got a great response.
Yeah, yeah. So it's gone for its third reprint now, so doing good.
Very good. Fabulous, I'm sure. So, and you're already working on your next one.
Yeah, I'm working on the sequel.
On the sequel of this. And that tells you, is going to tell us about your later years then? Is that also going to be
a guy goes to the engineering college.
Okay, great. We do have Mr. Chetan Bhagat, who probably went through a similar kind of a journey with his writing.
Well, I don't know if I can compare myself to anybody as of now, but yeah, I enjoy writing and that's what I'm trying to do.
Fabulous, Saurabh. I must tell you, Vineet had a very interesting, little bit of information when he sent us about himself. He calls himself an avid swimmer, a bonfire guitarist, a gaming enthusiast, and a road trip junkie. And I must share with you here that this is in addition to the fact that he does have, I think, the distinction of being the youngest CEO ever. Is that right, Vineet?
Of a multinational advertising agency.
Oh, great. I missed that crucial point. So, Vineet, how do you get the time to write?
There was this interview I was giving to one of the newspapers, and there was this beautiful journalist sitting in front of me, and she asked me the same question. And you're equally beautiful.
What a coincidence, huh?
Yeah.
Similar people, similar questions.
Absolutely. Similarly beautiful, like I said. And she asked me the same question, and I said I very simply said, because I don't watch movies on weekends. And she laughed. And after that she said, no, seriously. But I was through with my answer. You know, I'd already given the answer. No, but on a more serious note, I think what is important is, especially for fiction writing, when I was writing Harappa, I think it was the most enriching, the most fabulous time of my life. I don't think writing for me is work. In fact, it is something which takes me away from all the hard work that we do in our corporate lives. So for me, every time I get an evening and I know I can steal a cup of coffee or a pint of beer and just lock myself in my study and spend 4 hours, for me it is most entertaining and most enriching. So I don't really have to look for time, I just enjoy it so much.
Yeah, I guess it comes from the fact that if you enjoy your work, you're technically not working a single day of your life. I guess that's where the thought is coming from, right? Okay, Archana, I went through a few of your poems and I felt that, there was a lot of prose in the poems that one read of yours. So you think that transition from a poet to an author could be happening anytime soon? Is there, would you see yourself turning into an author anytime soon?
Okay, I need to learn how to use a mic. I think it's working, thanks. Okay, I thought, number one, let me say that I thought poets were included. So am I on the verge of turning into a fiction writer?
Or just a
novelist? That's almost, in a way it spooks me because that's what I think I'm headed in that direction. It's very perceptive of you. I can see this.
Just want to read it in your. I mean, I don't know. I somehow, you know, I somehow read it in your poems.
And the answer is yes, because I think that there's seeds of stories in some of the poems, like Lord of Ice, even in My Immaculate Conception, and a whole bunch of other poems. And I've written two short stories, and I have a novel in my mind, and I think I will be working on that in the months to come. And learn from my colleagues.
Sure, thank you. And Saurabh, what is the most interesting incident really in your book, and how have, I mean, do you have the youngsters kind of any interesting questions that have come your way from the youngsters after they've read your book, really?
So I'm basically an 80s kid, okay? I was born in 80s, I was raised in 80s and 90s. And the parenting then was more hands-on, right? So, aajkal mandir mein jaise prasad milta hai, waise hamare yahan pe assembly ke baad mein maar milna in school was very usual. Because teachers would hit you for no reason whatsoever. Aapne school, aapki laces side nahi hai, and you'll get slapped. It was not like today ke agar
the teenagers or the kids today won't understand that at all.
So, aaj agar kisi bachche ko thappad pad gayi, to probably uska dono ka paper mein photo aa jayega, bachche ka lal muh ke saath mein, teacher ka kaale muh ke saath mein. For us, getting famous was not so easy, right? So, agar aapko school mein breakfast mil raha hai, to aapko do time ka khana ghar pe hi milta hai, right? Aur jo hamare time ki jo mammiyan hoti thi, wo they were like they used to move like ninjas, and they used to hulk, hit like a hulk, okay? Aur वो निंजा भी वो इच्छाधारी निंजा होता था, ठीक है? मतलब अगर उनको इच्छा, इफ शी वांट्स शी कैन मेक, शी कैन वॉक लाइक एन अर्थक्वेक, इफ शी वांट्स शी कैन वॉक लाइक अ स्नेल्स विस्पर. तो अगर मैं और मेरा भाई ऊपर लड़ाई कर रहे हैं, एंड मॉम सेज कि यार कौन ऊपर जाके उनको दूर करेगा, तो मॉम बस दो स्टेप लेके और हम बोलेंगे मॉम आ रही है दूर. और यहीं अगर मैं किसी लड़की से दूर वाले बेडरूम में फ़ोन पर बात कर रहा हूँ कि हाँ क्या कर रही हो, अच्छा क्या पहना है तुम्हें, तो गर्ल्स लाइक टू टॉक अबाउट देयर क्लोथ्स, लाइक मेरा क्या पहना है अपना, कौन से कलर का पहना है, पीछे देखा मम्मी ने कहा मम्मी तो घर पे भी नहीं, आप आए कब? सो
सौरभ, मॉम्स हर सदी में ऐसी ही होती है.
नहीं, पर आज मुझे पता नहीं, आज मैं बताता हूँ, लेटेस्ट दो हफ्ते पहले का किस्सा है. तो माई फ्रेंड हैड कम होम विद हिज किड एंड हिज वाइफ. तो वो उनका दो साल से तीन साल का बच्चा था, तो उसने माई फ्रेंड स्मोक, तो एक सिगरेट का पैकेट पड़ा था, उसने बच्चे ने उठाया कि पापा ये क्या है. तो फ्रेंड ने कहा कि बेटा दिस इज चीची, थैंक यू सर. तो उसने कहा थैंक यू. मैंने कहा हाँ, 15 साल बाद बच्चे को याद रहेगा कि पापा ने चीची कहा, तो ये सिगरेट नहीं पीनी. फिर उसने उठाया एक रिमोट उठाया कि पापा ये क्या है. बेटा ये रिमोट है. फिर ओके रिमोट करके थैंक यू, ये क्या है. फिर उसने पापा का चश्मा उठाया, अरे पापा ये क्या है. तो बेटा दिस इज पापाज आइज. उसने बोला पापा आइज को भी थैंक यू. मैं कहता एंटी शरण कुमार है, मतलब माँ बाप की तुम आँखें मत बनो, कम से कम आँखें फेंको मत. देन उसने मेरा मोबाइल उठाया, मैं कहा यार ये इसको ये कुछ नहीं है, फिर चुपचाप रख दीजिए. बट इतने में पापा ने कहा जिस अंकल सुबह उसने फेंक दिया. तो मेरे को पहले दया आई, पहले गुस्सा आया ऑफकोर्स कि इसने मोबाइल फेंक दिया, तो मुझे दया आई. मैं कहा बेचारा कितना बुरी तरह पिटने वाला है. इसकी मॉम दौड़ कर आई, मैं सोचा कि रोकूं, मैं कहा नहीं है, दिस गाय डिजर्व्स इट, ही शुड गेट द लैश. इसकी मॉम ने बोला हां अयान हां,
दैट्स इट.
मैं कहा हां, मैं कहा मेरे 50,000 का फोन टूट गया, हां क्या है ये. एंड देन फिर उसने मेरे को पूछा कि अरे आपके फोन में गोरिल्ला ग्लास नहीं था. मैं कहा नहीं, मुझे नहीं बता, मैं घर पे गोरिल्ला आने वाला है, गोरिल्ला ग्लास नहीं लगा. तो आई थिंक दैट्स द पैराडाइम शिफ्ट व्हिच हैज हैपेंड. तो द टाइम दैट वी हैव ग्रोन इन, तो हमारे यहाँ पे जो आप इंसिडेंट पूछ रही, हमारे स्कूल में एक क्लास टीचर होती थी जो कि यूजुअली लैंग्वेज पढ़ाती थी. उनकी हॉबी हुआ करती थी बच्चों को सुधारना, और उनका सुपर पावर हुआ करता था कि शी कुड स्लैप फास्टर देन वी कैन टॉक. तो वो मैं 8th स्टैंडर्ड की बात है, तो मैंने बहुत मुश्किल से, तो आई हैव अ ब्रदर हु इज 2 ईयर एल्डर देन मी, सो आई ऑलवेज गॉट हिज हैंड मी डाउन टू वेयर, ओके, हमेशा उसी के पैंट्स पहनता था. लेकिन मैंने सोच दिया था कि 8th स्टैंडर्ड में, बिकॉज दूसरे स्कूल से लड़कियां हमारे स्कूल में आने वाली थी, मैंने बोल दिया था मुझे दो खुद के नए फुल पैंट सिलवाने हैं, कुछ भी हो जाए. तो मैंने बहुत पढ़ाई की, जम के, और दो फुल पैंट सिल गए. और होता क्या ना, देन अगर आप खुद की गाड़ी में, नई गाड़ी में जा रहे हैं, तो आपको लगता है कि सारी की सारी नज़रें आपकी तरफ है. तो उसी तरह जैसे मैं अगर खुद का फुल पैंट पहन के 8th में जा रहा हूँ, तो मुझे लग रहा है कि इट्स इक्वल टू ड्राइविंग अ लैम्बोर्गिनी इन पनापुलिस. मैं कहा सारे के सारे लोग मुझे देखेंगे, शायद कुछ लोग कंधे पे उठा रहे हैं, कुछ लोग नीचे बिछ जाए कि मेरे ऊपर से चल लो. लेकिन मैं कहता हूँ कुछ ऐसा हुआ नहीं, नोबडी इवन बॉदर्ड. मेरे बेस्ट फ्रेंड ने मुझे पूछा है कि तुमने ऐसा क्या कहना.
So next day I was very, school, koi dekhi raha hai, kya matlab hua. I was very despondent. And I went there and I entered off, main late pahuncha, class mein sirf first bench khali thi. And I was like, kya karo, first day baithi hai, baithi hai. Yeah, hamari teacher. Normally lal color ki badi bindi lagati thi, blue color ki saariyan paayi jati thi. Hamare time ka female team hui tha. So, wo aayi piche se bole, Saurabh, baith jao. मैं खाऊंगी
नहीं
है आप खाते हो और आपका खाया हुआ पानी भी नहीं मांगता तो मैं वहाँ बैठा इतने बस आई वाज जस्ट सिटिंग देयर एंड द गर्ल एंटर्ड हर नेम वाज अनया एंड एज शी एंटर्ड तो आई वाज लाइक डंबफाउंडेड एंड शी सेड के मे आई कम इन आई विल जस्ट जॉइन इट एंड बोला मे बी आई सॉ हर व्हेन आई जस्ट हिट प्यूबर्टी और आई हिट प्यूबर्टी व्हेन आई जस्ट सीन हर आई डोंट नो एंड वो कुछ लड़कियां होती हैं इनको देख रहता है कि न जाने लगता है कि मेरी जिंदगी तेरी गली से होके गुजरेगी आधी शायद रो के गुजरेगी आधी खो कर गुजरेगी बट आई एम फाइन विद दैट तो वो वाली फीलिंग आ गई तो वो अंदर आई तो और होता क्या ना आई वॉज एन इंट्रोवर्ट बैक देन इंट्रोवर्ट्स टॉक द मोस्ट टू देमसेल्व्स सो आई स्टार्टेड टॉकिंग टू माई सेल्फ शी इज कमिंग एंड आई वाज लाइक क्या हो रहा है तो अचानक से मेरे को आवाज़ आती है हे इट्स ओके यू नो शी हैज कम यू कैन ब्रीथ हैवी ये कौन बोल रहा है तो इट वॉज माई लंग्स टॉकिंग टू मी मैं ये क्या हो रहा है इतनी लड़की आके बैठती है एंड शी स्टार्ट स्माइलिंग मैं स्माइल तो मैं लिफ्ट में से बात करेंगे व्हाट इज दिस हाउ डू आई कंटॉर्ट माई सेल्फ टू मेक इट लुक लाइक अ स्माइल मैं आई डू व्हाट आई हैव टू स्माइल एंड आई स्माइल एंड देन शी सेज हाय एंड आई फील कि मेरे यहाँ पे कैक्टस उग रहा है और माई थ्रोट स्टार्ट सिंगिंग द सॉन्ग बिस्ती गोरी लो खिंच खिंच दूर करो मैं कहा क्या करूँ एंड सम हाउ आई मैनेज अ हाय एंड चल मैं कहा हो गया अब ये टीचर जो थी ये क्या करती थी अगर आप क्लास में टेक्स्ट बुक नहीं लाते हो तो शी वुड स्पैंक यू लाइक क्रेजी और आप अगर वॉर में जा रहे हो ठीक है आप स्वॉर्ड ले जाना भूल जाओगे आप शील्ड ले जाना नहीं भूलोगे तो आई वॉज ऑलवेज इज माई शील्ड विच इज माई बुक मैं कहा बुक ले जाओ तो कम से कम मारनी पड़ेगी पर बच्चे फिर भी भूल जाते हैं और आप अगर अगले दिन पिछले दिन मर भी गए हो लेकिन आप अगर क्लास में टेक्स्ट बुक नहीं लाए तो आपको मार
अगर आप सब कुछ हमें यही बता देंगे तो आपकी बुक हम कैसे पढ़ेंगे सोचा कि मैं किस किस को जाके कहानियां बताऊंगा तो मैं बुक लिख देता हूँ जिससे कि सब लोग मेरी कहानियों को अच्छे से पढ़ लें आई एम गोना कम बैक टू यू बिकॉज़ यू स्टिल हैव टू टेल अस अबाउट दैट वन इंसिडेंट दिस वाज नॉट दैट वन राइट
जस्ट अबाउट टू
ओके सो वी कम बैक टू यू
श्योर
दैट
इज सॉरी फॉर कटिंग नो नो एब्सोल्युटली
नॉट आई थॉट बिफोर मैं फाइनल दिस आप विल बी वेरी पार्शियल टू
यू नो 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 नो
आई मस्ट गो बैक टू द मोस्ट प्लीज ओके अर्चना to you first and then I shall come back to Vineet. Archna, there are not too many, not so much of an audience for reading poems as there is for, the authors do tend to find a bigger target audience. They do tend to find, a larger number of people who would like to read their words. उसका आईडी एक कुछ काउंटर पॉइंट होता है वो ये होता है कि लोग जो पोएम्स लिखते हैं वो हमेशा ही कहते हैं कि वी राइट पोएम्स मोर फॉर आवर सेल्फ दैन फॉर द वर्ल्ड सो व्हेन अ पोएट इज सेइंग आई एम राइटिंग इट मोर फॉर माय सेल्फ दैन फॉर द वर्ल्ड इज इट काइंड ऑफ हाइडिंग बिहाइंड दैट शील्ड और हाउ डू यू एक्सप्लेन दैट एंड व्हाई वुड यू चूज टू बी अ पोएट एंड नॉट एन ऑथर और हाउ डू यू डील विद दैट डू यू फील बैड एट टाइम्स अबाउट इट
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes,
I can. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Thanks. That is a great question. I think I started writing poetry not thinking whether I'm writing it for myself or for someone else. I was just compelled to do so. And that's the form which found me. And I think that's what you hear from publishers. It's publishers who say that poetry doesn't have an audience, but I think things are changing. Because if you look at the origins of poetry, right, or of literature, actually they say it stems from poetry, and which is connected to music and rhythm, like dithyrambic poetry, ancient Greece. And if you look at the contemporary era, poetry is coming back onto the streets. Like you have street poetry, you have slam poetry, spoken word. So I think it's coming full circle. So I think that would be my response to it. And sometime back you actually asked me whether I'm shifting towards or moving towards fiction. I think so too. But I would continue to write poetry. I have a third book of poems for which I have sufficient poems, and also a bunch of short stories in my mind.
Yeah, that's another Nirvana, right? Which shall see the light of the day next year.
Yeah.
In 2018. So that's the next book, which is already worked now. It's gone into publishing or
very soon. It's coming out in spring 2018. Just in a couple of months, I've signed the contract for it. So it's going to be out.
So from the first fire to another Nirvana. I'm sure that's going to be quite a journey, or there must have been quite a journey since you've already completed that journey.
I think it was quite a journey. The title of my book, First Fire, I'd like to read out the title poem once.
I would definitely have you read that out, Archna, definitely.
And I think in a way it's connected to another Nirvana, because this book and the poem is the result of a very deeply transformative experience which led me to become the Archna I am today.
Yeah, but that's the thing with poems, right? That's what they do, right? To the poets, they kind of help you evolve, and they help you really discover yourself to a very large extent. More than prose would do. What do you think? I'm talking to both of you. Does a poem, or to all three of you, does a poem really help you evolve as a person, or recognize you as a person far more than prose does, probably?
I guess it's words. It's words that evolve you, and the way you put it, it can be put in prose or poem, but I guess the words are the healing things, which heal you through whatever you go through every day.
Just to respond to you, sir, I totally agree. Like I said, I think it's words which find you and the form finds you. Sometime back, Vineet talked about transformation, right? Her writing transformed him. So I think it's life experiences which transform you or change you or do something to you, and then you want to put that into words. And the form doesn't matter, really.
Okay. I really didn't know how time just flew, and what is the time right now, really? Okay, so not too much time, guys, for the four of us. It became what Vineet just said when the moment we sat down, he said we really don't, it's going to be more like a conversation, and I think we guys just got so lost in this conversation that we just lost the track of time. A quick question to Vineet here, because he did send me a clipping. It was quite a coincidence that this morning's DNA carried a little article which kind of wondered in print whether his book, his debutante fiction book, Harappa, Curse of the Blood River, is actually slated to be the next Bahubali. So Vineet, even though we don't have a Karan Johar or an Aditya Chopra in the audience, that's it, but you never know. Chandigarh has really rich people, and I can see a few faces here that could really be producing your book into a movie. So please answer that question in all earnestness.
See, I think the reason why DNA wrote about it, and the reason why a lot of readers, hundreds of them, are writing to me and insisting that we should convert Harappa into a movie. A lot of them are saying we should make a TV serial out of it, because they feel that 3 hours or 2.5 hours won't do justice to the book. So I think it is nothing but a manifestation of the boundless love that Harappa is receiving from thousands of readers. It's a book which, if you would all remember, when was the first time you heard about Harappa? We all read about it in class 6 in our NCERT books. And we were told that, Harappa was the oldest civilization, and the Great Bath and Mohenjo-Daro and all of that. And they suddenly told us that, that's how the civilization ended. And we were like, how? And lots of other things. Was there really an Aryan invasion that happened in India? Did blue-eyed, riders gallop through the Khyber into India and beat the, the indigenous people? Was the Saraswati River really there? So Harappa is an attempt to bring all of this together, knit all of this together. And I think that's what readers are finding very interesting, and which is why you read such things.
And we would, I'm sure, love to see it being made into another blockbuster of the Bahubali kind. I don't have too much time, but I can take one quick question from the audiences in case there is a question there. Guys, can we have the mic, please? Malika? one. Okay, two questions and that's it. Okay, Supreet, that's one. That one's for you.
Hello. Good afternoon. You just mentioned whether or not. So was there really Aryan invasion? Because my surname is Parmar, and what our ancestors tell us that the word Parmar is taken from the Param of Aryans. And it was a huge dynasty that ruled whole of India. Even the city Bhopal is was ruled by a Parmar king. And we have Parmars in MP, Himachal. So what we are constantly told that we are the Param of Aryans. So was
were the Aryans really?
So that's a I have studied as far as what I have researched, and I think I've researched pretty deeply. I don't think there was an invasion. I don't think Aryans were outsiders. Okay. There is an entire genealogy-based research that has just come out, which says that there is a certain hereditary gene called R1N1A, which is common between all Indians, whether they are South Indians or North Indians. Okay. There are 100 such, facts that will that point to the fact that Aryans were originally Indians. That Aryavart, the entire northern India was called Aryavart because you know it was run and ruled by the Aryan people. When you see the excavations of the Indus Valley civilization, you will see that there were gods like Pashupati that were being worshipped there. There were ritual pits which were essentially Vedic rituals. So like I said, you know, I'd love to have this discussion.
No, but one small thing, okay. As you mentioned that all the Indians have the same DNA. So people have migrated over centuries to each other this thing. We also have the swastika, which was also rotated anti-clockwise and used by Hitler. And he never actually considered Indians to be Aryans. So maybe the immigration...
Like he said, I'm sorry for cutting you short, but we're really, really, really short of time. And he said there are 20 pages dedicated to this in the book. So the thing to do is to get that guy signed from him and read it, right? Okay, last question.
Instead of a question, I have a request to Saurabh. Can you please finish the story?
Okay. Your books. Thank you, Saurabh. Thank you, Archana. Thank you so much, Vineet.
Thank you, such a pleasure.
And thank you all for being a lovely audience. Thank you so much.